Put your two hands there for Jesus.
Amen.
I want you to give somebody a high five and tell the person, you are welcome into the presence of God. You can get about, you give about five people high five. I want you to see some movement. Hallelujah.
Amen. Shalom, shalom.
I'm going to put this one on YouTube. Don't mind me if I'm fussing.
I have a message from the Lord. Hallelujah. The message of to you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. To be in Boston. I want to thank all the earlier workers. Because Potiphar is here. I already told you that Boston is a very good church. Then when I came here, I have seen that there is a plaque on the church, and I realized that it was Apostle Atta who also purchased this building, right?
Yeah.
So I have called him. And I told Apostle Atta, you did a good job. So all the patriarchs, if you like, who started the work here, they did a great job. I said, if you enter into any atmosphere, and the power of God is at work, you can design it. So we thank God. We also want to thank our first lady of the nation. That she has chosen to worship with us this morning. We also want to thank everyone here who has come to see off our mommy even as she transitioned into retirement. The elders here to once say, God will bless you. Instrumentalists, you are awesome. Hallelujah. Musicians. I brought this verse for you to know that retirement is God's own
idea.
Retirement is not one of the philosophies of men. But retirement is God's own ordination. That after a man has labored, he ought to take rest. But then this is what God said. He said, when you retire, I'm about to say something that goes to Mama Georgina. God says that from the 26th. It says, if another version uses the word, you shall no longer be in active service. But then this is what you shall do. You shall minister with your brethren in the tabernacle of the congregation to keep the charge.
Now, who got question? Who did I know? Aye, nyamiti ejuma.
So, in other words, you are supposed to assess those who are in active service.
Now, look, she said, "I was there." Opuawa, okuso aye ejuma.
If you read other verses, you see it over there. So, what we are doing today is that Mommy is being retired from active service. Everyone say active service.
Active service.
But then, she's supposed to assess those who are in active service. How is he going to assess those in active service? I have said here on Sunday occasions that if you really want to understand the mind of God, you must always read your Old Testament.
Now, I've been now, my culture was a self-assaulting of me as a Messiah. I was a being now quite a pandemic.
Because whatever God will do in the New Testament, He already piloted it in the Old Testament.
Now, when I'm here, I'm a pandemic. A pandemic, I'm a pandemic.
So, retirement idea, He already showed us that He spoke unto Moses that delivered. Actually, there may be someone who will say, well, Mama, the Christ is not a Levite. The Levite, they became the priest. Today, you are also a priest. Bible says in 2 Peter, right? Mm-hmm. Chapter 2, verse 9, that for we are a chosen generation. You are a royal priesthood. So today, you are a Levite.
And the man said, I'm going to say, I'm going to say, I'm going to say, I'm going to say, I'm going to say,
so we are following God's ordinance from Old Testament. But now we want to know in detail what is she supposed to do.
Now, as she
assessed those in active service, I want to make sure that my message is balanced so that it doesn't appear as if I'm only speaking to Mama Georgina. I just brought this to let you know that retirement is not the idea of man. Before Americans would think about 401k, Ghana would think about pension scheme, God already talked about retirement scheme.
Now, as an American for a 401k, that kind of force you say, oh, for retirement, not when you have to share after whatever.
So now let's open our Bibles to Titus chapter 2.
Titus.
And then we shall also need Luke chapter 8 from verse 41 to 55. That's a very long reading, so we'll need someone to read for us. Luke chapter 8, verse 41 to 55. That will be the last. So we have three quotations today. The first one is Numbers, which is on your program. The second quotation I brought is Titus chapter 2, 1 to 4. And then we shall zero in on Luke chapter 8, 41 to 55. I need two people to read for me, Titus 2, 1 to 4, and then Luke 8, 41 to 44. I hope we don't take long. Yes.
Titus 2, 1 to 4.
Mm-hmm.
You, however, must teach what is appropriate to mm-hmm. sound doctrine. Teach the older men
Can we get the King James?
Sure.
To read for me the King James.
The King James Version.
Mm-hmm.
Excuse me. But speak thou the things which become sound
doctrine. So the Bible says we should speak the things which become sound doctrine.
And we see a man chachira a china nyamia samso.
So this one I will speak some words over you.
And if you're not a cancer,
and they shall become.
Now,
read on.
Amen. That the aged.
So the aged men
mm-hmm. be sober.
So now he's talking to men who are old. If you are old, you see, normally when you get old, then you go to retirement. So he's actually talking about the people who go on retirement. So if you are a man here and you are retirement, this is your role in the church. You should be sober.
Mm-hmm.
Continue.
Be sober,
uh-huh.
grave,
mm-hmm.
temperate,
mm-hmm.
sound in faith,
mm-hmm.
and charity in patience.
That's right. Now let's go to the women's side. Look at what the retired women are supposed to do.
The aged women.
The aged women, likewise.
that they be in behavior as becometh holiness.
This is God's mind concerning you, that even as you move to retirement, this is your role. Continue.
Not false accusers.
So they will not accuse people falsely.
Not giving to too much wine.
Of course, Mama Gina will not go and bring some potassium. You read them.
Teachers of
good things. Pastor, it is the word of God. We must make sure.
Teachers of good things.
I have sent an aeroplane and somebody, I miss somebody, he says he's a leader of this church at the airport. And I helped him get his luggage because I was using the church brand. Because the plane had left Philly Airport and the plane was moving to JFK. So for us to catch that same plane, we have to drive from Philly Airport with a church van and go to JFK. And I met this gentleman who says he's an elder of the church. And we packed all his things into the van. We got there, got on board the plane, we're fine. Then I saw that we were bringing the normal food in the plane. Where I was sitting, I could see the guy. And he was taking this alcohol. I said, wow. I hope when you sit in an aeroplane, you don't take the wine much more.
Asam pe bi amene ko fu enpe na pe ya chiche ensa anu ya chi na pe mi twa mani na papa ya jibi wonso tell pe mu a me di ensa anu ya jibi
mi so bi o se etu ma wu didi kakra
and some people say it is able to help you to eat well,
but the word of God says that you must not be giving to wine.
Na nyame asam te yen se yen ka ne ho emma ensa anu ya jibi.
So read on.
That they may teach the young women to be sober.
So here comes your role. So Mama Georgina, as you retire today, God says you should teach the younger women. They are what?
To be sober.
To also be sober. So the younger women here, Auntie Georgina has a role to play in your lives.
Amen. And then you teach your and say, I was here, Mama, or church there. Emmanuel, only uncle, whom you say, when you
read on.
To love your husbands.
So Mama Georgina, who has amassed so much experience because you have been married for a very long time, right? She is going to impart onto you. Amen. So you know how to love your husband. Really?
To love your children.
Yes. And even your children.
To be discreet.
To be discreet.
Chaste.
Keepers at home.
Good. Obedient to your own husbands.
Wow.
That the word of God may not be blasphemed.
So you see, even though you are living active service, you still have a lot of work to do. Somebody say, a lot of work. Now let us read Luke chapter 8, 41 to 55. That's the last verse, and then we will discuss the word of God.
Luke 8:41-55.
Let me help you. And behold, there came a man named Jairus, and he was a ruler of the synagogue, and he fell down at Jesus' feet, and besought him that he would come into his house. For he had one only daughter, about 12 years of age.
So take note of the age. She was 12 years of age. She was a daughter. This is a younger person.
And she lay a dying.
But she lay a dying.
But as he went, the people thronged him. And the woman having an issue of blood 12 years, which has spent all her living upon physicians, neither could be healed.
So the woman, this is the older woman, she also has an issue of blood for how many years? So I want you to know it is not a coincidence. God is a master planner. So the two individuals in that story, there is an older woman and a younger one. So take note of that. Freedom.
Came behind him and touched the border of his garment. Immediately, her issue of blood stanched.
Amen.
And Jesus said, "Who touched me?" When all denied, Peter and they that were with him said, "Master, the multitude thronged thee and pressed thee, and sayest thou, who touched me?" And Jesus said, "Somebody hath touched me, for I perceive that virtue is gone out of me." And when the woman saw that she was not hid, she came trembling, and falling down before him, she declared unto him before all the people for what cause she had touched him, mm-hmm. and how she was healed immediately.
Mm-hmm.
And he said unto her, "Daughter, be of good comfort, thy faith hath made thee whole. Mm-hmm. Go in peace."
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah.
Whilst he yet spake, there cometh one from the ruler of the synagogue house, saying to him, "Thy daughter is dead. Trouble not the master."
Mm-hmm. Speed.
And when he had come into the house, he suffered no man to go in, save Peter and James and John, and the father and the mother of the maiden. And all wept and bewailed her. But he said, "Weep not, she is not dead, but sleep. 53. And they laughed him to scorn, knowing that she was dead.
Mm.
54. And he put them all out, and took her by hand, and called, saying, "Maid, arise." And her spirit came again, and she arose straightway, and he commanded to give her meat.
Amen.
And her parents were astonished, but he charged them that they should not tell no man what was done.
It's okay, thank you very much.
Amen.
Amen.
Somebody put your two hands together for Jesus.
Now let us go into the word of God.
Titus is saying that
we should speak those things that become sound doctrine.
Now, I said, yeah, can you hear some?
Hallelujah. I have noticed that God changes three things in 3 weeks. God can bring change in many ways. But this one I want to show you about 3 ways that God brings changes. The first one is that God takes something and turns it around. God can take something and turn it around. So we sing a song and say that he turned my mourning into dancing. I came mourning, but God has turned my mourning into dancing.